How late in the day can I drink coffee without it impacting my sleep? That's the question we're gonna answer in this video. Most sources say around 6 hours before bedtime is okay to have a caffeinated beverage. However, as I was doing my research, I just found so many case studies saying otherwise for very specific scenarios. So I'm gonna break down all of the different scenarios saying why some people can drink coffee 1 minute before bed, and some people shouldn't be drinking coffee at all if they want to have a good night's sleep. The first typical scenario is the recommendation that most people say online, which is around 6 hours before bed. This also means that most people are good to sleep after one half-life. Paul, what's a half-life? It's not the game half-life by Valve. It's actually a science term to define how long it takes for something to break down into half of its size. So caffeine has a half-life of 6 hours, meaning that after 6 hours, the caffeine amount in your body will be halved. And then you'll have to wait another 6 hours for that caffeine amount to be halved again. As an example, if I drank a cup of coffee and it had 90 milligrams of caffeine, after 6 hours, I would have 45 milligrams of caffeine in my body. And after 6 more hours, I would have 22.5 milligrams of caffeine in my body, and so on until it's fully removed from your body. Now, it takes around 4 to 5 half-lives for any drug to fully leave your body. This is an interesting one. If you're a smoker, a study has shown that caffeine's half-life can be reduced by around 50%, and it makes it okay to drink a caffeinated beverage around 4 hours before bedtime. And if you are over the age of 65, a study shows that you metabolize caffeine around 33% slower than normal. This makes it okay for you to drink a caffeinated beverage around 7 hours before bedtime. You might be hyposensitive to caffeine. This means a decreased sensitivity to caffeine. Around 10% of the population are considered hyposensitive to caffeine. In this case, you can drink coffee right before bed and sleep like a baby. On the other side of the coin, if you are hypersensitive to caffeine, any dose of caffeine, regardless of how small it is, will have a big impact on your sleep. Assuming you drink one cup of coffee right as you wake up, you want to have zero caffeine in your body before you sleep. It takes around 4 to 5 half-lives for any drug to leave your system, and that is around 24 to 30 hours. So, sadly enough, you can never drink a cup of coffee at any time of the day to have a good night's sleep. That's just how it is being hypersensitive. You can consume a few things that slow down the half-life metabolism of caffeine, making caffeine stay in your system for a longer time. These things include items like alcohol, grapefruit juice, and birth control pills. To my surprise, drinking water only seems to reduce the side effects like jitteriness, but not really impact the half-life of the caffeine in your body. The only thing I found that will increase the caffeine's half-life, meaning leaving your body quicker, is working out. Because working out promotes blood flow, which moves your blood through the liver faster, metabolizing the caffeine at a higher rate. And that's all the different scenarios. So it's not as simple of an answer as you would expect, because it depends on your body, sensitivity, age, vices, consumption, and so on. If you want to learn more about dark and light roast coffees and how their caffeine levels are the same, check out this video right over here. And if you perhaps want to get into home roasting coffee, then I would recommend you checking out this video over here that talks about if you should get into home roasting coffee in the first place. I'll see you there.